Hey everybody, Chris here from O'Reilly Auto Parts. Today I'll be talking to you about spark plugs, specifically how to check them, how to set your spark plug gap, and how to replace them. This is a 2008 Dodge Nitro, but a lot of the same things will apply to spark plugs from any vehicle. As always, it's important to know the manufacturer's specifications for your vehicle before getting started. If you're not completely comfortable doing this yourself, we'd be happy to recommend a professional technician in your area. If you've decided to do this yourself, gather your supplies and remember, spark plugs are very fragile and can be damaged easily. Be as gentle as possible anytime you're handling, loosening, or tightening them. You'll start by laying a fender cover across both fenders, or whichever side you plan on doing first. This particular engine is forward facing, so you'll have plugs on both sides. It's also a good idea to unhook the negative battery terminal. You may need to gently move hoses or wiring out of the way to give you room to get to the coil connectors. Once you have room, unplug the coil connectors carefully. They may be brittle. If they're extremely brittle, they need to be replaced. Unbolt the coil hold-down bolt. There's usually only one. Once loose, take the coil pack by the housing, not the connector, and gently pull out with smooth, increasing force. You may need to unplug fuel injector connectors if they're in the way. Once the coils are removed from their holes, look in to make sure there's no debris or broken pieces of the coil boot. All debris needs to be blown out or vacuumed out before the plugs are removed so that nothing gets into the cylinders. Now time to remove the spark plugs. Take the spark plug socket that fits your plugs and put it down over the plug, making sure it is fully seated as far down as possible. Loosen the plug by turning it counterclockwise and try to keep the socket as straight up and down as possible in relation to the plug. If your socket gets out of alignment, it could crack the ceramic on the plug and cause debris. Look at each spark plug as it's removed to see if it has any lines that run from top to bottom that won't wipe off with a rag. These lines are from carbon tracking and indicate that you need to replace that coil boot for that cylinder. It is highly recommended that if you remove a spark plug, you replace it. Plugs can sustain micro fractures when you remove them that can cause problems if you continue to use them. Once you've removed your old plugs, you're ready to install the new ones. So you'll check and, if necessary, set the gap at the end of the plugs between the center electrode, here, and the ground electrode, here, even if they're brand new out of the box. First, you'll need to know the manufacturer's specified spark plug gap for your vehicle. Then take your gap tool. You'll see rounded spokes around the disc that measure specific gap sizes. And start with the spoke that's the recommended gap size for your vehicle to see if the plug is already where it should be. If the gap is too large or small, use the tool either to bend the ground electrode down gently to make it smaller, or carefully bend it up away from the center electrode to make it larger. Then remeasure the gap to see if you've corrected the space. It's very important not to touch the center electrode or the insulator during this procedure, since they can be damaged. It's recommended you change coil boots with spark plugs. So if you are, go ahead and change out boots on the ignition coils and lay them out to be reinstalled once the plugs are back in. Gently insert the first spark plug into the socket, making sure it's fully seated. Then gently thread it into the cylinder by hand without power tools, making sure it threads in smoothly. If it isn't going in smoothly, remove it and check the threads for damage. Then try again, making sure it's straight. Using a torque wrench, tighten the plug to manufacturer specifications, keeping the socket as straight as possible in relation to the plug. Now reinstall the ignition coil. Apply a little bit of dielectric grease, cover about 1/4 inch of the coil where it contacts the top of the plug once in the hole. Gently push downward until the coil is within 1/16 inch of where it bolts down. Reinstall the hold down bolt in the coil. Replace the coil connector and anything else that you disconnected and move on to the next plug. Repeat these steps until all the plugs are back in place. If you remove the air filter inlet tube earlier for the sake of space, you can reinstall it now. Reconnect your negative battery terminal, Lastly, start your engine to make sure it runs smoothly. And that's it. You'll find everything that you need for this and other jobs at your local O'Reilly Auto Parts store or O'ReillyAuto.com. Our DIY videos are designed to help answer questions that we get in our stores every day. If you found this one helpful, subscribe to our channel to get all the latest. We'll see you again soon.